What's up, guys? So I know a lot of you have been watching me for a while and have watched a lot of my college videos and videos that I make about college experiences and everything like that. I wanted to really take a look at the last 4 years and all the lessons I've learned and the amazing experiences I had in one little wrap-up video. Without further ado, freshman year. The year was 2013. I just graduated high school. I'd lived in small town Oregon my entire life for 18 years. And suddenly I was packing up my life to drive down and move to Southern California to start school at Chapman University.
College, wow.
To be completely honest, I hated college in the beginning of it. Starting this whole new life was really exciting, but I absolutely despised the whole orientation process. I'm not a super like outgoing, bubbly, gonna be best friends with everyone after 5 seconds of meeting them kind of person. And there were so many people that were like that, and it was just like a lot. Although orientation week was like the worst thing for me, I ended up loving it. I went through recruitment and joined a sorority, Cap Alpha Theta, which became my home away from home. Cheesy. At first, my roommate Chloe and I were like super different. She was like the outgoing, like best friends with everyone kind of person, and I was like the please hold up, don't hug me kind of person. But the first couple weeks, like, it was just kind of like distant, like respectful, whatever. We weren't like friends, but we joined the same sorority, and not saying like that's what made us friends, but like after that, we really like opened up to each other and we got so close, and she was like my best friend freshman year.
Another thing I'm worried about is what if me and my roommate don't get along. Since I've been talking to her and everything, there's nothing that's really making me think that we won't get along or anything, but just, you never know someone until you live with them.
Chloe's wearing a striped sweater. What does that mean?
The best friend wore a striped sweater all the time.
Stole Kristee's camera, stole Kristee's camera.
Vlogmas day 7, no regrets.
Beans! We would laugh for hours, and our room was just like ridiculous, and we decorated together. I had a Disneyland pass and I abused it. I went probably at least once a week, sometimes more than that. Every Friday was like religiously a Disney day.
What if I buy an annual Disney pass and then I barely ever go because I'm so busy, and then I paid like a ton of money and it's not even worth it? Actually, I'm not that worried about that. I'll probably be there every weekend.
And we're at Disneyland. Say hi!
Hi!
Mickey, you're your biggest fan! Okay, the wind is slipping my ears! Freshman year, I started taking classes in my major, political science, where I took an international relations class, and I fell in love with it, and I was like, this is what I want to do. I did Vlogmas on my vlog channel that year, which everyone loved this Vlogmas, and it's honestly like one of my fondest memories to look back on, because like I watch those vlogs and it brings me back to those just like blissful freshman year days. One of the most like beneficial things for me freshman year was kind of expanding my social circle and getting to know people that were so different from me and came from such different backgrounds. One of my best friends was my sweet mate Angel, who everyone loved on my vlogs.
That wasn't me. It wasn't me.
Then who was it?
Shaggy.
And she is from Taiwan, and I never met someone from Taiwan, and like I learned so much from her just about like life and differences, and she literally moved across the world to go to college at Chapman. I totally know what she's saying.
1, 2, 3,
go.
You're there.
I ran into Monica and Shelby Church, and they like randomly convinced me to go to playlist with them, and I was like, okay, I guess I'm going to playlist. And that like especially reiterated to me just how distant I had become from YouTube, and I didn't feel like I was a part of that community anymore as much as I was like a part of my college community. I went to Coachella the first time my freshman year with some of my really good YouTube friends, and we had an absolute blast. It started to come to the end of the year, and I was like, what is college outside freshman year? You know, closing the door to my dorm for the last time and not getting access on my ID card and everything like signified so much more to me as like closing the door on one of the best years of my life.
So last night, how do you feel?
It doesn't feel like our room.
I know, it doesn't. All the things are gone from the walls.
And I was kind of just in this like blissful bubble of college, like happily living in this bubble. Pretty soon that bubble was kind of popped in sophomore year. It was three of us living in a one bedroom apartment. I was so excited and moving in, and it just felt so fresh and free to have an apartment as opposed to a dorm. Orly, one of my best friends, came to Chapman that year as a freshman, so that was super cool to know someone, you know, from outside of college that came to my school. The jacket was too hot, so I had to take it off. I met my little, who became one of my best friends to this day, but I didn't expect to find, honestly, like a lifelong best friend as a little. I just wanted someone who like we got along. We came back after an event at like a sorority thing, and the next day my roommate was like, I met this girl last night at the thing, and she was super just like quirky. Something about her reminded me of you, and I was like, yeah, right, like if anyone's like me, they're probably insane, so why would they be in the sorority? So I randomly messaged her on Facebook and I was like, let's go to Disney together, and we did, and I became obsessed with her after that one day. Like, we had so many inside jokes. We laughed at the same things. I feel like everyone has a different moment when it really clicks with them that their sorority is like where they're meant to be. And when I got Lauren as my little, I finally felt that click of that deep connection that really tied me to the sorority. But despite that, after like October, November, things started to kind of go downhill for me, and sophomore year was one of the hardest years of my life. I was just not happy at all, and I was not myself, and I just like, I felt like I was just kind of going through the motions of life. A lot of that I think could be attributed to my living situation. I don't know how to describe this without like making me sound like a victim, but it wasn't like, and they weren't even doing anything wrong. It was just like the nature of living with three people. I just felt kind of like isolated, alienated, and I kind of like did it to myself. Like I didn't feel like myself, so I was like pulling back. It was just really hard because I didn't have my own space, I think ultimately was the problem. I'm an introverted person who like needs my own time, and I didn't have that. Like I really, really tried to hide it, and I don't think you can really tell in my YouTube videos. I broke down and cried on the vlog, and I talked about in the vlog, I was like, I'm just like getting so stressed from school, I think is what I said, but like it really wasn't that at all. I've just been really kind of stressed, and it's just, it's hard for me to deal with it because I'm not someone who ever really gets stressed. I'm talking about this because I want you guys to know that in college, like, it's not always happy, perfect, fun memories. It's like, there are ups and downs, and you are gonna experience downs. Sophomore year especially, like, you come off this high freshman year of like this new experience and being alone and independent for the first time and making all these new friends. And then the newness wears off. That's when I decided, like, I need to go do something different, put myself in a different environment, so I need to go abroad. So that's when I decided to go on semester at sea. So sometimes you need those, like, hard times to really motivate you to seek something different. And then I went to Coachella again, last minute spur of the moment decision. I wasn't going to go because the lineup wasn't as good, blah, blah, blah. My roommate, Marissa, who wasn't my roommate at the time, she's just my friend, posted, like, on the Kappa Alpha Theta page, like, hey, we're looking for a roommate, and I was like, me. And so I remember literally being at Coachella in the morning, like while my friends were pre-gaming or something, and I was sitting on the patio like talking to Marissa about housing. And that is when my current housing with like Marissa and Sierra and them all came together, and it was the thing I needed the most. At the end of sophomore year, I turned 20. I moved into my new house on June 1st with Marissa, and I met Sierra for the first time. She lived in the same apartment building as me the entire sophomore year, but I just never known her. Like, we didn't meet until the very end of sophomore year because she and Marissa had already decided to live together and got this house together, and that summer was such a good time for me to kind of like detox this bad phase of life that I'd gone through and really feel like myself again. So that was sophomore year. Not the best, but it was necessary. The first semester of junior year was spent like getting ready to go abroad, doing things for Chapman, getting visas, like taking my classes, whatever. And then, you know, the end of the semester, I was packing up. I had to pack up my entire room because there was a girl subleasing from me. So I had to pack it all up and put it in the garage, and it was so sad. I was in a really good place here, and like, I felt like myself again, and I was making like such good friendships, and I got really close to Sierra the first semester of junior year, who's like one of my best friends now. I packed up and went to San Diego to board the ship that I would live on for 4 months. I cried like the morning of. I literally cried like in the registration building. Left my life behind, and I got on the ship, the World Odyssey, and we sailed away from San Diego. Adjusting was hard. It was very, very hard for me, and I think that's something I've learned about myself like through college, is like, I love new experiences and putting myself in new places and adjusting to them, but in the beginning, like, I always hate it. Like, I hated orientation week, I was so unhappy, and then the first like 2 weeks on semester at sea, I was so unhappy too, and I was like, it was just so hard to adjust for me. I wasn't like getting that close to people yet, and I am someone who just like, I take a long time to let people in, so I think that's really what holds me back in these like new situations. It's like, I like hold myself back in a way. So it was really hard for me on a boat. Once we got to Japan, I kind of like made friends like thrown together almost. Like, we were going to Tokyo and we had no place to stay, no plan. And we randomly like ran into these girls in the lobby of the port after we kicked off the ship. Like, they didn't have a place either. And we're like, okay, let's just go find somewhere together. And like, they became my best friends. Being on the ship and not being able to leave and adjusting was hard. But once we got there and started traveling, like, it all fell into place, and I fell in love with it. So I made all like entire videos about my experience with semester at sea, so I'm not gonna go too in depth with it because that's like also not applicable to most people in college, but it was like the time where I learned and grew the most in my college experience. So I definitely encourage every single person to go abroad. Challenge yourself to go to a place that's uncomfortable for you, because that's where you're gonna learn. That's where you're gonna grow. I got to live out my dreams. I've always wanted to go skydiving. Like, it's like the number one thing on my bucket list my entire life. And then I got to skydive in Cape Town, South Africa with the view of Table Mountain and the ocean. And it was just like, I rode a camel through the Sahara Desert in Morocco and camped in the Sahara Desert. Like, semester at sea, walking away from that gave me such a new zest for life and such an appreciation for like every moment. In 3 days, we would be doing so much that it just gave me like this new perspective on how much you can really fit into your life if you put in the effort to get that kind of experience out of it. I didn't want to just like sit on my bed and watch Netflix in my free time anymore. Like, I wanted to go out and do something and really like challenge myself more. Leaving semester at sea was particularly difficult because I knew it was an opportunity that I was never going to have again. So junior year was really the year that I learned how to push myself out of my comfort zone and how to enjoy life by challenging myself every single day and, you know, seizing opportunities for myself. Finally, we come to the last chapter in my college experience, which was my senior year. This is when I started to get serious about the future, you know, that like towards the end of this summer, I'm really thinking about it, and it gave me a lot of future anxiety. Future! My roommate Sophie moved into our house in August, and Sophie was a theta also, and we had like hung out a couple times, but I didn't really know her that well. And she quickly became like one of my best friends also, and I absolutely love living with her. I think it was after the first week of school, I flew to Washington, D.C. to go to Playlist Live D.C. I remember walking around the streets of D.C. and thinking like, this could be where I live next. And I absolutely loved the idea. So then after I got back, I was slated as the chief recruiting officer for my sorority, which is something that I'd always wanted to do. Sorority recruitment kind of became my life first semester of senior year. Also during the first semester, I decided to take the Foreign Service Officer test. So to become a Foreign Service Officer, you have to take this like government issued test, and it's really, really hard. I did a lot of reading. I had an app on my phone that had like practice questions, and I felt really prepared. Like, I felt like I was knowledgeable. I failed the test. Like, I knew I was gonna fail, and it was mostly just like to get a feel for the test. I wanted to like see what it was like for the future reference. At the same time, like, I kind of hoped that I was like the 1% that would pass, but like it didn't happen. I didn't study for the GRE at all, which is like the standardized test you need to get into grad school. Most people do like insane major preparation for the GRE, and I didn't study at all. And that's like, I'm not condoning that. That's not smart.
How are you feeling?
I'm great. Ask me any question from the GRE, I will answer. So that was kind of like this whole future denying phase. I didn't study for the GRE, I wasn't motivated, I didn't really care. In January, as my Christmas present, I surprised my best friend, my little Lauren.
Excuse me, I think you dropped something.
Oh my God!
I'm coming to Europe with you. Hi!
And I crashed their trip to Europe in January, and we went to Europe together for 2 weeks.
Oh look, a clock. We don't have those in America.
I literally was, oh God, you guys don't take advice from me, like at all. When I got back from Europe, I had a timer on my computer counting down the 3 hours I had left to submit my grad school applications. And I was writing my personal statements. And then I came back from Europe and I did recruitment, and it was so much fun. And I like got so close to everyone, and like, I just like felt such a theta high after that, because like I felt so proud of myself and my entire sorority for coming together and doing this. And I just felt like we had a really, really successful recruitment. Not like we got the best new members, but like we had an amazing bonding experience, and like it was just awesome. I took a sociology of death class this semester, and on the first day we wrote a letter to ourselves for the end of the semester. And I was thinking about like the end of the semester, what I would want to read and how I was going to be graduating college. And like, it was such a weird moment for me writing this letter that I literally teared up, like starting to cry writing it in class. I remember writing the letter like, hopefully you actually know what you're doing with your life by now, like good luck, I'm so excited for you, blah, blah, blah. Oh, by the way, in October, I applied to be an intern for the State Department in DC for the summer. As soon as I like wrote that letter to myself, I handed it into my professor. We left the class and I checked my email and I got an email that I didn't get the internship. You're not gonna get everything. You're not gonna get most things. Like, it's okay. Like, but at that moment I was like, oh my God, like my life is over. What am I gonna do in the future? I'm not gonna get into grad school, blah, blah, blah. I started to write my two thesis papers, which were the bane of my existence. Here's fun parts of senior year. I randomly went to Cabo San Lucas for spring break with Sierra and Orly and we had a blast. I was sick actually, so I wasn't to my full potential, but I really tried and I had fun. It was beautiful. I did skit for my sorority, which is like this huge Greek life competition. It's like such a big deal at my school. And we did Little Red Riding Hood, and we did, for the granny part, we did this whole like jazzercise class of a bunch of grannies, and I was a granny in it. So much fun. I absolutely love skit. I got an email from American University. Your admission decision has been posted. Please email us if you have questions. And as soon as I read that, I 100% thought that I was rejected. I had like accepted that I wasn't going to grad school at this point. And like a dumbass, I didn't open my admission decision on their website. I just was like, this is rejection. A few days later, like maybe even a week later after I'd accepted I wasn't going to grad school, I got a call from a Washington DC number and I was like, that's weird, but I get a lot of telemarketer calls, so I thought it was just that. But then I left a message and I listened to the message and it was this girl that was like, congratulations on getting into grad school at American. Like, I'm here to answer any of your questions. And I literally was sitting there in awe, like, what? So I remember opening the letter online that was like, you're accepted, like, welcome to the program. And I like almost started crying. After like failing the foreign service officer test, which obviously I failed, like it's not meant for fucking like 21-year-old, like not getting the internship at the State Department that I wanted so bad. And I just felt like really discouraged, and like getting into grad school was such an accomplishment for me. There is life outside of college and I can do it. Me and my roommates did our fair share of having like crying sessions together throughout May. And I like pulled my shit together and finished my thesis papers. I had to think about like saying goodbye and all this stuff and got ready to graduate college. It's really hard to leave behind the best years of your life so far. Just because you've had some of the best years of your life doesn't mean that there aren't more to come. College was such an amazing 4 years of, you know, independence, growth, learning, sadness, you know, struggling with myself, finding where I thrive and what I need in life and the people that I need to surround myself with in order to like be the best version of myself. I learned, you know, my limits of what I can do that I didn't think I could and things that hold me back. So 4 years ago, I was sitting in this room talking to this very same camera about like I had decided where I was going to college. And how insane is it that 4 years later, like, here I am sitting here again, reflecting on these past 4 years and what I've learned. I'm so grateful to have had all the opportunities that I've had and to meet all the incredible people and have the experiences that shaped me into the person I am today. And it is hard to say goodbye. I look forward to the future without fear of the things that I'm gonna encounter. And I feel like I'm ready to like live life. As senior year came to a close, Sierra, my roommate, who's my best friend, was telling me like, when are we gonna decorate our grad caps? Like, what are you gonna put in your grad cap? And she kept talking about this grad cap thing. And I was like, does it matter? Like, who cares? I wasn't even gonna decorate mine. I was like, maybe I'll put like something, like, I don't know. Most grad caps are overly cheesy anyway. I thought about this Steve Jobs quote that I had heard a long time ago. And I feel like it just really encompassed the lessons and like self-discovery and experiences I had throughout college that I wanted to emulate throughout the rest of my life, moving on and graduating.
When I was young, there was an amazing publication called the Whole Earth Catalog, which was one of the Bibles of my generation. It was idealistic, overflowing with neat tools and great notions. And then, when it had run its course, they put out a final issue. It was the mid-1970s, and I was your age. On the back cover of their final issue was a photograph of an early morning country road, the kind you might find yourself hitchhiking on if you were so adventurous. Beneath it were the words, "Stay hungry, stay foolish." It was their farewell message as they signed off. Stay hungry, stay foolish. And I have always wished that for myself. And now, as you graduate to begin anew, I wish that for you. Stay hungry, stay foolish. Thank you all very much.